Hi, and citizens, welcome back to my channel. Today we have 127's dance practices. Now I got a little bit behind on these, so because of that, we're gonna be doing lemonade, sticker, and favorite today. Now where I usually like will pause in the middle of this and like talk about separate movements, I think I'm just gonna summarize it all at the end of each video because I have to do all three. But before I get started on this, my NCT life reactions have been getting blocked. I don't know why the first few got through, but these recent ones haven't. That's why they haven't come out in a while, but I'm going to try a couple of other things, and if those don't work, that may be the end of, like, NCT Live reactions. I may be able to put them on Patreon, but last time I tried to work with my Patreon, it was a hassle. And it also, I feel like it wasn't, the views weren't matching, like, the hassle it took to put into it. So, but I will start their analog trip reactions when those drop, and I think the first episode drops within the next day, so I'm super excited for those. And I think because those are being put on YouTube, I shouldn't have a problem reacting to those, unless they put their like music in it, because I know that was an issue with Stick Together. I think it was Dreamer was the beginning song or the intro song before the video, and because it played Dreamer, it kept wanting to get blocked, so I either had to like mute it or cut it out. But hopefully those will be fine, so be on the lookout for those when they come out. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get started into the lemonade dance practice. I love watching 127 dance. I mean, they are all spectacular dancers. I feel like SM, people talk about SM's vocalist a lot, but like you have to look at the dancers that come out of SM Entertainment. They're absolutely phenomenal. I mean, excluding NCT, you have Taemin, you have Kai. Karina is an exceptional dancer for her generation. So was Winter. I'm trying to think. Hyoyeon. I mean, there's so many that I can think of, and most of those were older generation, and I'm not even thinking about literally all the Neos that can dance. Literally all the Neos can dance. So, but with that being said, let's go ahead and get into Lemonade. Nantes, this is most of our dance line right here. I love the incorporation of the like old choreo that Taeyong does. And here's the other part of our dance line. I
Youth Center.
I don't know how many stages of Lemonade I saw. I guess like three, because those are the, I think those are how many they promoted with. But watching the dance practice really showed how like difficult that dance routine was. I mean, it's extremely fast paced, and you have to have a lot of stamina and a lot of endurance for it. Also love the fact that 127's choreo always plays to whoever's center. So like when Taeyong is center, the choreo is very like Taeyong style. However, like when Jaehyun was center at the very end, it was very groovy, which I feel like Jaehyun does very, very well. And that's one thing I'll say is NCT's dance line, or 127's dance line, like you have Mark and Taeyong who were main dancers, but Mark and Taeyong have two very different styles. Like, you can put them next to each other and they can be doing the same choreo, but it looks completely different because they interpret choreo completely different. But it's amazing because it's still in sync. They're still synchronized and it still looks good, even though they have their own individual takes for it. And that's a lot of the 127 members will do that. So it's always, like, really cool and really fun to watch their dance practices because you really get to see how 127 interprets their choreo. So, but love Lemonade. I mean, they killed it. They always do. But 127 is definitely needs to be talked more on the dance side. I know a lot of people talk about their vocals. Mark and Taeyong are very well known for their rap styles. But we need to talk about their dance because it's so good. Okay, so now we're gonna go on to Sticker. Love, love, love Sticker. Saw every single one of these stages and they killed it every single time. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get into Sticker. Just think about it, we got Taeyong hip thrusting in both title tracks. See, the more like groovy style fits Jay very well. They do boss. That was one of my favorite things about their choreo this year, or this era. Also, their ability to like be clean and do extremely fast paced movements while changing formations. Exceptional. This reminds me of Chain. That one section. Haechun's iconic slides. Jungkook also needs to be talked more about his dance because he's amazing. Yeah, their transitions are extremely difficult. This is my favorite part of the choreo. Look at that footwork. That dance break is so incredibly difficult. Oh my goodness. The footwork by itself is extremely difficult. I mean, and then you add the formation changes and the arm movement. It's just crazy. It's insane. I feel like people were too busy talking about that whistle or the flute. To really take in the entire, to everything that Sticker was bringing to the table, because the song was good, the choreo was exceptional, their stage presence was always amazing. But man, and I talked a little bit about separate people and separate individuals, like Haechan, that iconic, like Haechan slide, I love it so much. And it's anytime they can incorporate it, Haechan is going to take advantage of it. Like he did it here. I know he does it in We Go Up. There's another MB that I'm thinking of, or dance practice that he does it in. But like Haechan, that is his move. No one is doing it like Haechan. Jungwoo did an exceptional job in this. But everybody, 127 has 9 amazing dancers, so you can't help but compliment everybody. And of course, like Mark and Taeyong, when they're center, absolutely attract everyone's attention, like completely dominate being center. Yuta center, I love Yuta, because Yuta's dance style reminds me a lot of Taeyong, is in the fact that I don't think many people could duplicate it. Like, you could dance the same steps as Taeyong and Yuta, but it wouldn't look the same. There's just something about how they dance that you know, and you can tell it's them. Whereas, like, Mark and Jaehyun and Jungwoo and Haechan, like, they have, like, the more groovy aspect to it. Super excited to get into Favorite. Haven't seen it yet, but I saw stills from it. And that new practice room is stunning. But it's also, like, extremely emotional, because they went from, like, having the sky and cloud background to actually having the, like, real sky and clouds as their background. So the glow up is very real, and it's just amazing to see how far they've come since they were rookies and training in that first practice room. But before I get into Favorite and talk about Sticker, I love Sticker. Sticker had amazing stages, and I loved every single one of them, and they nailed it and killed it. And like I said, their stage presence is off the charts. Side note before I continue this, Taeil singing so many high notes and killing it in a center dance position, yes sir, our king. Back to this, so many stunning stages. Favorite's first stage, for me, just blew every single sticker stage out of the water. I don't know what it is about this choreo, about this song. Literally the outro is what you hear when you enter the gates of heaven. Those vocalists are absolutely stunning and absolutely something else. They're so majestic to listen to. But the choreo is also like very innovative. I feel like that's a perfect word to describe 127, is they're extremely innovative. But everything. I literally, watching that prologue, because I tweeted something about this and I was like, because I think I saw the prologue, the announcement that they were going to have a prologue maybe hours before M Countdown even started. And I was like, if that prologue is anything like the prelude for Kick It, it's going to be the most magical thing ever, because I love the choreo for the prelude for Stick It, probably because it is extremely different from the actual choreo of Stick It, from the actual choreo of Kick It. I keep wanting to combine them, because Kick It is more punchy, whereas the prelude was extremely groovy. A lot of body rolls, a lot of just more fluid movements rather than sharp and hard angles and hard lines. I don't know what it was about Favorite. My jaw dropped at the beginning of that prologue and just stayed there until Taeyong laid back down at the end of it. It was just, I was blown away by it. I'm addicted to this whistle. This whistle is something else. It stays in my head all the time, and it's so beautiful to go along with these beautiful vocals. It was like they took the perfect amount of everything that makes 127 127 and put it all together. And I said this during my reaction to it, or doing the album reaction to it, which I'll probably also get out today. It feels like every SM song put together was Favorite, because there were so many SM songs I was thinking of after this song was released that didn't sound anything like it, but still gave me the same feel. It was absolutely bizarre, but it was like, if you had to pick a song that represents the SM sound, it's this one. I don't know why. I think it's just like the perfect blend of like Girls' Generation and SHINee and EXO and Red Velvet and literally everybody combined. That's the exact feel I get from this song. I could be the only person that feels this way, but it was so weird. Like, I listened to it and I immediately thought of like Bambi by Baekhyun. Bambi sounds nothing like this, but like my head went to it. And it's just, this song is different. The song is very different. All that had nothing to do with this actual dance practice, but with that being said, let's go ahead and get into it. It's 5 minutes long, so I'm wondering if they're doing the prologue and the actual dance. Because if they do, that prologue choreo, killing it. So let's go ahead and get into this dance practice. Why does this remind me of Hello Future? Okay, Taeyong. Oh my god. It literally looks like they break their legs. Okay, Mark Lee with the fit. It's like they're waking up. I love how they incorporate this story into their choreo. Get it. I think I just like Markley in a snapback. Ooh! Hayton's put his head all the way back. I love this choreo. Come on, Hayden. That section reminded me of Turn Back Time. See, it's just like elements from different songs. It's how I feel watching this. Okay, Jungwoo. I love that note of Jungwoo's. Don't you just love when Do Young comes through with the most magical vocals? Like, that's so good. It's just like a simple ripple, but they make it look so amazing. This outro. I love who's counting. Oh, I love how they always like die after completely killing every in-citizen ever with their amazing dance skills. You know what else I noticed? Johnny is always in those like little small sections with the like really difficult. It's usually like with other members of the dance line, but I don't think Johnny is technically a part of the dance line. Like, it reminds me of that Kick It section of like Taeyong, Mark, Jaehyun, and Johnny. There's just different little sections like that, and I feel like Johnny's always a part of them. Literally, like, watching this choreo, I could just see, like, elements of other groups. And it's not, like, taking movements from other choreos and putting it in 127. It's like, oh, this resembles some other choreo. And there's 100%, they probably, like, for a fact, did not do this. but I just thought how it, like, coincidentally, how I feel about the song, it also incorporates how I feel about the choreo. That there were just so many elements that resembled other songs that, but had their own 127 flavor. So it's just that the whole this part, it's so good. It's so good. Why doesn't anybody talk about 127 as a dance group? I mean, this was so good. This was the perfect way to end my day. I loved this. I'm so sad it took me forever to actually react to these, because I could have been watching these all the time. But I'm definitely gonna go watch this again, go watch the MV again, go watch their M Countdown performance again, because whew. But everything about this was so good. I, like I said, watching 127 dance is like one of my favorite pastimes, because they just nail it every time. It's so good. You give 127 like any type of choreo and they're gonna kill it. I saw somewhere that someone was like, yeah, 127's choreo is not TikTok friendly, and it's really not. It's almost impossible to learn, and once you do learn it, one, it's not gonna look as good as 127's does, and two, you're gonna be dying by the end of it, because it's just so hard and it takes that much endurance to go all the way through. And the thing is, the power does not diminish at all throughout the dance. Like, how hard they're hitting movements and how powerful their movements are at the beginning is just as powerful there at the end. I mean, they just, there is something else about these guys. So, I mean, like, literally every NCT unit has amazing dancers. So, I can't applaud them enough, can't praise them enough. They did an exceptional job, and I can't wait to see their performances for the rest of the week. And I don't know if they're gonna perform next week. Maybe not, or they might only have 2 weeks, I'm not sure. Part of me wants to say like their last promotion is November 6th, and then part of me also, or 6th or 7th, and then part of me also wants to say it's the 1st. So I'm not 100% sure which one of those is actually accurate, but I know it ends the sometime during the first week of November. So however many stages they have left, I'm super excited to watch them. They looked stunning in that like first prologue outfit, and those beaded black coats, oh my God, are the most beautiful thing ever. The beading on it is so intricate and amazing. I love it. They're so good, and they looked amazing last night. So. And usually like their outfits get better throughout the week. So I don't know how they're going to top that. I'm interested to see what Inkigayo looks like, because Inkigayo usually is out of this world. Because for some odd reason, everybody dresses the best on Inkigayo. Like Music Core and Inkigayo always have phenomenal outfits. But applaud these guys. I'm probably going to go scream about this on Twitter after this. So. But with that being said, thank you guys for continuing to love and support the channel. Love the 127 guys. Love the rest of the NEOs. Super excited for whatever comes next of NCT, whether it's NCT 2021 or they're going to take a break and do NCT 2021 at a different time or whatever it may be. I've been seeing a lot of their invitations for the SM Halloween party, which someone deemed it the Met Gala of K-pop, and it really is, honestly. I am never jealous of idol life until I don't get invited to the SM Halloween party, because it always seems absolutely spectacular. So, but whatever they do, I'm excited for it. When my favorite albums get here, I'll definitely do an unboxing. Honestly, I'll probably buy some more albums. I don't have the money to buy some more albums, but this one was it. I don't know what it is. This should be getting a whole lot more love than it actually has been, even though like the views like skyrocketed. They got like 20 million views extremely quickly, which is why they dropped this so early. It's definitely done extremely well, but I always feel like it could do, they just deserve the world. But super proud of these guys. I just, like I said, I can't praise them enough. But be on the lookout for my next NCT reaction, and I will see you guys next time. Bye, in citizens.